and how many you have two years. And tier 2 years and one leg is short and not one leg is short and short. Can you go back sitting with your back?
Legs.
Yeah, legs. Can you see this leg? Come here closer. You see, this is short and not one. What's your leg?
Shelby.
God, I thank you for healing right now.
There she goes, just push the shoe back on.
No, it's not short. Try to stay up.
Let's watch this again with no sound on. Gets the leg out, ask the cameraman to come in. Watch the left foot. He pushes the shoe, you can see him do it. Look at that, look at his hand. If this is for God, why does he need to do this trick? Look again, watch. Watch. Pushes the shoe back on, look at that. Watch closely what he does, pulls it out. You can see him pushing the shoe back on again. And it all depends on what type of shoes these people have as well. He's a charlatan. See what he does with this one again. There we go. And he pushes it back in. Watch this one and you'll see him push the shoe out. There you go, you see, did you see the heel of the shoe? Let's see that one again. And again, proving that it's Torben doing it. And you'll see very, very clearly what he does. Trying to get into it right. Watch. There we go, pulls it out, look at that.
What is the gospel? This is the gospel. When Peter rose up on Pentecost and they asked him, what shall we do? He said, you have to repent. Call on Jesus, repent. A new life is starting inside of you. Then you have to get baptized down under water and rise up again. So you're a new creature. And then you have to get baptized with the Holy Spirit. Receive the Holy Spirit. And the sign is always speaking in tongues and prophesying.
Did you catch that? Torben says that baptism is always followed by tongues and prophesying. That is not true, my friends, and this is just one thing Torben twists. Let's listen to that again.
And then you had to get baptized with the Holy Spirit. Receive the Holy Spirit. And the sign is always speaking in tongues and prophesying.
I was in Canada a short time ago. I was preaching the gospel. Many people came and chose to be baptized, but a few came to me and said, Torben, you need to baptize me. I want you to baptize me. And I said, no, I did not come to baptize, but to preach the gospel. Did they get baptized? Of course, because the gospel is baptism. But I did not baptize them. They got baptized, of course, because the gospel is baptism, but I did not baptize them. And there's people who are quoting me for saying something I don't say. I encourage everybody to go in and see the 20 lessons on the Pioneer School. Go in and see it.
If you go on the internet today and write, is baptism necessary for salvation? They will quote the hard part of this, the hard part of this, and then they will quote what I have in my hand. And try to do it, try to go in, just, it's so funny, go in, write on Google, is baptism necessary for salvation? Find some of those articles where I say, no, it's not. And you will see this quote taken out of context, because it's actually talking about baptism. This quote taken out of context, because it's actually talking about baptism. And then this quote taken out of context. Corinthians 1:17. Paul says, for Christ sent me not to baptize, but to preach the gospel, not with wisdom of words, lest the cross of Christ should be made void. Look here, Torben, look here. Christ did not send me to baptize. Paul says, Christ did not send me to baptize, but to preach the cross, to preach Christ. But this is not what he's saying. He did not say he did not baptize. You have to read text in context. And this is often those people think they are so smart and we are the one with the sound doctrine who are quoting that. Try to read it. You are part of a conversation there where Paul is saying that there's division in the church. Some say I belong to Apollos, some say Caiaphas, some say Paulus, and some say Christ. Have Christ been divided? Was it me you got baptized to? Was it Paula? Who did you get baptized to? No, you got baptized to Christ. So they're talking about who they were baptized to or who they got baptized by. We also say like that. And they discussed that. And then Paul said, hey, stop. Christ did not send me to baptize, but to preach Christ. He did not say he did not baptize because he said, I'm happy I did not baptize any of you there. Okay, I baptized him in his house and I baptized them and I baptized them. So he baptized them actually. But he said it in that context. Like I, a few weeks ago, was in Canada and I quoted this scripture in the right context. Because what did I experience in Canada? Somebody came to me and said, Tom, you need to baptize me. I want you to baptize me. I have just preached the gospel about repentance, baptism, water, Holy Spirit. 130 people want to get baptized. And somebody came to me and said, Tommy, I need you to baptize me. Do you know what I answered to him? No, for Christ sent me not to baptize, but to preach the gospel. Did that mean he did not get baptized? No, because he got baptized because the gospel is part of, baptism is part of the gospel. But he
didn't. All right, as we saw, it's almost the same as the last video that we watched. But we see here that he says that baptism is part of the gospel. Again, we look at the verse, we look at the context of what Paul's talking about, that's simply incorrect. That baptism and the gospel are two separate things, that no one is saying that baptism is not important. And there's an aspect in there too that Torben didn't mention, that were you baptized in such and such as name? But Paul also says, was Paul crucified for you? We see also in the context that it's ultimately about Christ and him crucified again, as we see in there. That's the whole context of Paul writing this. That it's not saying that baptism is not important, but Torben seems to completely miss the point over and over. It's very troubling, actually. Now, as we heard here, he said, when you look up anything that says, if you look up, does baptism save? And someone says, no, that is to say, he's actually saying he believes baptism saves. Now, almost every Christian would say, the person who says baptism saves is a works-based salvation. That is to say, they believe their works will redeem them. However, one important point to stress right away is we want to say this, that the Last Reformation isn't wrong on everything. There are certain things they get so right, but there are these small things that they get wrong that tend to go by unnoticed, and it makes it so deadly.
Do I believe that baptism is part of salvation? Yes, I do. Of course I do. This is what I read in the Bible. Do I believe that baptism saves us? Yes, this is what I believe. But. I'm not saying that if you're not baptized, you are lost forever. It depends. I believe that baptism saves us, but not in that way that baptism in itself saves and is enough. No. We need to get saved, and the one who keep on to the end shall be saved.
The fact is, Torben, is that you keep saying baptism saves, and then add but, and try to explain why it's not only baptism that saves. The truth is that baptism has nothing to do with salvation. Repenting and putting your faith in God is all that needs to be done to be saved. This is a different gospel.
So, but I believe, if you ask me, can Christians have demons? I believe, no, the answer is yes, they have.
Okay, a true born-again Christian cannot have a demon. 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. So he's a new creature and the old is gone. So there cannot be a demon left over. You will see that even Torben's partner agrees with this. But the next clips are probably the most disturbing with this movement. Torben repeatedly baptizes new converts and then starts babbling in tongues and casting out demons from them. This is a misuse of tongues because Scripture says that two or three at most should speak in public, and only if there is someone with the gift of interpretation. And secondly, I believe that these are demonic spirits being imparted on these poor people. This is not biblical.
The reason why I believe we're seeing this happen now is because when that old man dies, demons lose their grip and their grab. They can no longer torment a dead man because the old man dies. And when you come out of that water, you're somebody brand new. There's a new man wearing your old clothes.
We are starting a battle. What is happening there is a wrong spirit. And there is this many people who have got a wrong spirit. And it's actually a false tongue. So as soon as he came out of water, he moved the tongue. It's not the Holy Spirit. This is a false tongue. But when that demon is gone, then he starts with the right tongue. Look.
Get out.
Go on, say that command, leave it, right now!
Come on! Go! Come on! Go! Come on!
Go! Leave her! Leave her! Go! Leave her!
Come on!
Go!
Come on!
Go!
Come on!
Go!
Go! Come on!
Go!
Go! Come on! Say something right now!
Okay, so you kneel down and you say, I baptize you to Jesus Christ, and make sure he come down. Die with Christ! Oh, with Christ! Shit up! Freedom! 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 Go, 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 freedom! 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 Come! Leave! Go! 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 I command speak! Go! Right now! Right now! Come on! Come on! Go! In the name of Jesus, I command speak! Go! Right now! Leave him! Right now! Out! 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 Go! In the name of Jesus, I command every demon! Go! Right now! In the name of Jesus, I command speak! Go! Right now! Come on! Come on! Come on! Right now! I command speak! Go! Come! Go! Right now! Demon! Go! I command every demon! Leave him! Right now! Lie! Go! Come on! More! More, more, let it go, let it go, let it go, let it go, let it go. I command you, demon, right now in the name of Jesus. Come out! Come! More, go! 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 In the name of Jesus, I command last. Go! Go in the name of Jesus, I command it, leave him. Come out! Right now, leave him! Leave him! Fill him up, fill him up, fill him up more. Freedom, 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 freedom. Why is there a fight going on? Because Sesam don't like it. But now we are going underwater. And then she's going to come up and you're going to see her freedom. You're going to see her freedom and a new life. Look at, just kneel down. Don't be afraid, lean down. Just kneel down. There's freedom. No, you can, you can, you can, you can, you can, in the name of Jesus, you can. You can, it's a new life. But Satan is a liar. Satan is a liar. He has been lying, and he don't want you to give everything over to Jesus Christ. Because when you give you over, he's going to set you free. And Satan's going to lose, and he don't
want. Now, like I said, I'm sorry to put everybody through so much of this, but it's important to see that this is happening in so many countries all over the world. And I just wanted to point out here that, as Torben said before, baptism is the gospel. Now, he was saying to this girl that she's giving her life to Jesus now as she's being baptized. Well, that's not biblical. You've got to repent of your sins, give your life to Jesus, and then you are set free. The baptism comes after. This lady looks terrified. Let's continue.
It's free, it's in you. Yeah, it's coming up.
You can.
Don't want to bend.
No, go down in the name of Jesus.
All right. Jesus didn't say,
and she wants to. She can. Her knees don't want to bend. She cannot get out. There is a fight going on. But in the name of Jesus, God, we thank you. Just go down. In the name of Jesus, just go down. Down, down. Just go down in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Go down. Go down. Go down. Go down. In the name of Jesus. Go down. Are you ready? Are you ready to get baptized to Jesus Christ? So on your own faith, we baptize you to Jesus Christ. Just go down. Die with Christ, up with Christ. Freedom, freedom, freedom. Say it, go. Leave her, leave her, leave her right now. Come out, come out, come out, come out, come out. Come out. Leave him, go, go, go.
Come out, come out, go, 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 go. Right now, go right now. Shut down.
Loose, 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 loose.
Go, 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 in the name of Jesus, I command this religious spirit, go right now, in the name of Jesus. Go, 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 go,
arbejder, der kan komme op. Så vi har ikke engang en flere kold vej, når vi nemmer til. Come on, Ryder! Come on, Ryder, man! Go! Go! Come on, now, Peter, run up!
Let it go!
I command this demon, go! I command this man to go! Go in the name of Jesus! Go right now in the name of Jesus! Get out right now! Go! I command that demon, leave him, right now! Come on! Everything's
out of my mind. That's coming! Come out right now! Come out! Come out! Come out! Come out right now!
Go! 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 And then what she's like, command is to leave him, right now! Right now! Right now! Right now! Come on!
Get out! Come out! Come out! Come out! Come out! Come out!
So there you have it, folks. We saw at the start of this video the leg lengthening scam that so many people like Pete Cabrera, Todd White, and Torben Sondergaard are doing that has been proven to be an old parlor trick. Atheists do it. People can do it without anybody there. It's been proven in my other video. You can see we saw that Torben teaches salvation is necessary for baptism, which is a works-based baptism. And we saw this crazy demon impartation, yet he calls it casting out, on baptism. Never did we see that in the Bible. Never did a newly born-again Christian who'd just given their life to Jesus have a demon when they were baptized. This should be a very exciting time. You're dedicating in public your life to the Lord. But most of these people were terrified when they did it, and then suddenly they have demons. He's speaking in tongues, which didn't sound like much of a language that the Bible says tongues were, and there was no translators around there. So these are just a few things to consider when looking at Torben, but this movement is spreading like wildfire. I know lots of people that are in this movement, and just like with any cult, they stand up for him. They say he's a nice guy, and I'm sure he is, but if we examine scripture, we can see that this is not biblical. But you decide for yourself.